In this video, I'll show you how to print Cyrillic on the IBM i with the use of Interform 400. The requirements are that you need to have installed Interform 400 on your IBM i, and you also need to upload a two-type font into the IFS and place it in the work folder inside of the APF 3012 home folder. After that, we'll install the two-type font in Interform for PCL, create a font number if we don't have that already, and then we'll link the two together, the two-type font and the font number, and then finally we can put it into production. And let me show you how it's actually done. We have already copied a two-type font into the IFS, so now we need to install it here in Interform. And we do it through option 80, administration, 4, work with fonts, 4 again, work with soft fonts, and here we can press F6 to load, for instance, an Arial, hit enter. Here we need to install it for Cyrillic, so that would be 5. We need to give it a name, for instance, Arial Cyrillic, and typeface. Usually this is not needed unless you are using InterWord. But here, the normal typeface for Arial is 16602. I already have a font number to link with this, so now I can go directly into auto-download, where I need to link the font number and my two-type font that I just installed. So I go into option 8, select the PCL printer group, option 8 again, F6, F4, and here I can find my font number that I want to use, for instance, Arial that I've created earlier on. Cyrillic, I need to select the same symbol set as I did when I installed the two-type font, F4, and select my soft font, my two-type font that I installed, and that's it. So now I have done all the preparation, and now I just need to put it into production. And in order to do that, we would normally set it up in AutoForms Control. So I've done that already. In AutoForms Control, I'm now monitoring this queue, this output queue, and here I've put it this code page, this Cyrillic code page to be used, and here for the merges, I'm just merging a spool file with a blank overlay. And that blank overlay is exactly using my font 5010, so nothing else is inside except for that. So if we just look into this output queue and release a spool file, then Interform will wake up and do the merge. So let's take a look at the merged spool file with SwiftView. We can see the graphical result, and here we have the Cyrillic result exactly as it would print out. For further information, I suggest that you consult the other videos we have on Interform on YouTube, or check out our manual. Thank you very much for your interest.